Dell's conservative in servers. Dell Regions became the number one in servers worldwide, unit volume, according to IDC, and by a reasonable mark in both the second quarter of last year and in the fourth quarter. Compared to the number two player in servers in the fourth quarter, we gained 600 basis points of market share. So we're doing exceptionally well in servers. That's before we even introduced the 14G. What we are doing, and the strength that Dell has in servers, and this is important because the industry is moving our way. And what I mean by that is in servers, there's multiple form factors. There is towers, there are blades, there's semi-custom, and there's rack scale. Now, rack scale is where Dell grew up and is the market leader that is contributing to a lot of that strength I talked about in servers. The rack scale segment of the server marketplace is growing at the expense of all other segments right now. Why is that? Because rack scale servers look like the web scale server deployments you see in hyperscale software companies and web companies. And that's what every enterprise wants to become. So what we just introduced with 14G will roll through the whole family, but basically the rack scale capability will be the core of that. And you saw a lot of innovations in there. If you get some time with Ashley later on during the week, ask him about what we've done with GPU, with cooling, with density, with NVMe drives. I mean, these are very advanced devices, and there's a lot of innovation in them, and you see that we're early to market with the new Intel technology. So this has been a very conscious approach. I think that as the industry moves towards the server-defined data center, if I can call that, powered by software, that software-defined data center has to run somewhere. That server-defined data center exactly plays to our strength historically and the innovations that you see coming from us. So I think we're exceptionally well positioned. I think that our historic strength is actually a good thing, and the innovation in 14G is huge. So I don't worry, I actually think we're in an advantaged situation, and as I said, the numbers speak themselves. 600 basis points of market share gain in the fourth quarter vis-a-vis our closest competitor. I think that's pretty good going.
If I'm not wrong, Michael Dell said on stage that Dell is looking at the startup. So I'm wondering, what is missing at Dell EMC portfolio today that would make sense to make more acquisition in the future? And being a private company, how is it easier to make moves to adjust the portfolio today?
Okay, great. Two very good questions. So what Michael talked about was actually spending more time with a new arm that we've just brought out of stealth today called Dell Technology Ventures. And what Dell Technology Ventures is doing, and has been doing for a little while, we just made a bigger thing of it now, is investing in early stage companies to look at the next generation of technology. So where are those investments going right now? Things like artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, things that will become mainstream in multiple years' time. So what we're doing with the startups, with the ventures, is looking at things that are going to be fueling the next big wave of technology adoption and getting close to those companies, understanding how they work. In some cases, being able to optimize our technology to work with them. In other cases, they may wind up becoming part of our portfolio. But as the largest infrastructure company on the planet, we want to make sure we're in front of and working with the new trends. So that's the focus upon startup. It's not a gap today. It's saying, hey, we know this industry is moving very, very rapidly, and where are the next innovations going to come from that will either create new applications or influence the way that our infrastructure works? And that's what we're doing with the startups. As a private company, a lot of great things. I mean, really a lot of great things. So first of all, we can take a long-term view. Of course, everybody has to deliver results, but our focus is upon delivering results over the long term. So we can invest with a longer-term horizon. We can do things that are important for our customers. So our customers increasingly want to buy and pay as they use, as opposed to buy everything as a big capital purchase up front. As a private company, we can lean into that model. As a public company, if you move everything into and as a service, your revenues will decrease very quickly. Your cash flows may be okay, but you'll have a big impact in the short term to your revenues and your operating margins. We can work with our customers and move more aggressively through that transition because we're focused upon the long-term results, which is market share gain, profitable cash flow generation, etc. So there are many great things that are coming to us from being a privately controlled company. And having come from the ex-EMC side and, you know, worked with the public markets for many, many years, I see and I touch many of those benefits. So I believe it's actually quite disruptive, and it lets us accelerate, in some cases, create some of these trends in the industry.